Hello, welcome back to my channel Awesome Learning. Children, we are doing the chapter Neural Control and Coordination. In this, the last video that I had uploaded was about forebrain. We have done the structure of forebrain. Now we are going to do the structure of midbrain and hindbrain in this video. So children, midbrain is also known as mesencephalon, as you see. And it is located between the thalamus or hypothalamus and pons. Just see the diagram here, very clear diagram of midbrain. Okay, a canal, that is cerebral aqueduct. If you see cerebral aqueduct, this is the canal. Okay, cerebral aqueduct passes through the midbrain. You can see cerebral aqueduct, a canal is given here, which passes through the midbrain. Okay, and midbrain consists of four round lobes called corpora quadragima. You see here, this is corpora quadragima. Okay, their anterior pair is the center for visual reflexes. That means they are responsible for your eyesight's visual reflexes. And posterior pair is a center for auditory reflex. That means your hearing. Okay, visual reflex is for eyesight and auditory reflex is for your hearing. Okay, the posterior pair is a center of auditory reflex. I'm talking about the corpora quadragima. Okay, the four round lobes. Then children, comes the hindbrain, also called as rhombencephalon. You can see hindbrain. It consists of three parts: cerebellum, this is the cerebellum, pons, and medulla oblongata. Okay. Now midbrain and hindbrain both combine to form the brain stem. Okay. The midbrain and the hindbrain both combine to form the brain stem. Now let's start with the cerebellum part of the hindbrain. It is also known as little cerebrum. Now children, you know that cerebrum was a part of forebrain. If you remember, cerebrum was a part of forebrain. This was cerebrum and this is cerebellum. So it is also called little cerebrum. It is very convoluted. You remember, jaise cerebrum pe convolutions thi, similarly here also it contains many convolutions surface to accommodate more neurons. The more amount of convolutions, the more amount of folds, the more amount of neurons will be fitted in. Okay, it coordinates muscular activities and body equilibrium. So cerebellum is responsible for all your muscular activities, whatever muscular activities we do, plus the body equilibrium. If we are standing, so we can stand straight. If we are sitting or lying down, there is an equilibrium so that we get a very good posture, right? So that is maintained by cerebellum. Okay, next we come to the second part of the hindbrain, that is called pons veroli. It consists of fiber tracts. Okay, fiber tract means there is a tract or a rasta through which fibers pass. It is a fibrous tract that interconnect different regions of the brain. So these fibers actually behave as a connector. They behave as a connector and connect the various parts of the brain with each other. It coordinates the activities of eye and ear and also regulates respiration. So you see, it coordinates. You see, you remember or you understand that whatever we hear, we try to see that side, right? So there should be a coordination between eye and ear. So this coordination is maintained by pons veroli. Then it regulates respiration. Okay. Next children, we come to the last part of the hindbrain, that is medulla oblongata. It is connected to the spinal cord. This medulla is now connected. It is carried forward to the spinal cord. It controls, this is the most important part, you know, because it controls very important processes in the body like respiration, cardiovascular reflexes, gastric secretions, peristalsis, etc. Okay, it also controls salivations, the saliva that we produce. बहुत अच्छा खाना देखते हैं तो अचानक से मुंह में saliva का production आता है, salivation, vomiting, sneezing and coughing, right? So this is all about your midbrain and hindbrain. Okay.